Hello, sports fan. This is Stephen Hill for Sports Choice Plus to bring you a very special breakdown. I'm going to be covering the NFL award projections, and we're going to be doing this. Before we get right into that, I want to make sure you're subscribed to the YouTube channel so you can get all the updates each and every time we have breakdowns here at Sports Choice Plus. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Without further ado, we're going to get right into the action. Looking at this year, this was maybe one of the most difficult years we've seen in a while from the NFL because of everything going on with COVID. And you're looking directly at some of the players that stood out on this list. You're going to have a lot of great players. And we're going to be covering some of the top MVP, Offensive Player of the Year, Defensive MVPs in a series of videos. So definitely tune in and check out each one of the videos so you can get those predictions right away. So we're going to start this video, and we're going to start this video with the Defensive Player of the Year. For the Defensive Player of the Year, it's very simple. I'm looking for guys who not only dominated game in and game out. I'm looking for guys who not only brought their hard hat to work, they came up, showed up, and it was unquestionable how dominant they were and how disruptive they were, no matter what position they played on the defensive side of the ball. So we're going to start. This is probably the smallest list I've seen in a while, but these two dudes, they did dominate. So the first guy I want to touch on TJ Watt, not only from the standpoint of just how he was able to disrupt from the defensive end position when he put his hand in the ground, but also from the linebacker position. There were several times where he put his hand in the ground and literally lined up on the side of the defensive tackle or either on the side of the defensive end and came around the corner and had one of his big sacks, one of his 15 sacks that led the NFL this year. And you're looking at how his target pressures, when he's hitting the quarterback, he's getting there and he's knocking the quarterback off their base before they can actually get the pass off, but it may not be a sack. He's leading the league in a lot of these pressures. But when you're looking just at his ability to come from anywhere and to cover and to tackle extremely well, he is a big reason why Pittsburgh is where they are right now record-wise. And you just look at all the injuries they've suffered from, and he still continuously came to work and put that effort in each and every week. It needs to be applauded, and he's one of the reasons why he's on this list, because of his effort, energy, and his attention to detail. The guy's balling out this year. He deserves his kudos and recognition. Coming in at number two, you're looking at Aaron Donald with 13 and a half sacks. You see the reason why each and every week he's battling double teams, triple teams. His jersey's getting ripped off by offensive linemen and tight ends and things like that. He's getting chipped, and he's still beating those blocks and still getting to the quarterback. You're looking just, and this is just a defensive tackle. This is his fourth year with double-digit sacks. That goes to show you just how dominant he is. And, you know, some people can get lazy. You know, they get a big contract. They get the big 100 rating on Madden. They can get comfortable. The guy is a work warrior. He is a main reason why this Rams defense is where it is in Los Angeles. And that's a big part of this. So, to me, it's a big, 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 big thing that he does each and every game, because the game plan is basically to stop Aaron Donald first and foremost. The rest of the team is pretty good, but Aaron Donald is elite. So to me, he's on this list because of that. And I believe, just being honest with you, these are the two most dominant players in the NFL on defense right now. If I had to pick one, I would definitely go with Aaron Donald. I know that TJ Watt brings a lot to the table of what he does for the Pittsburgh Steelers, but I look at the Pittsburgh Steelers being, before the injuries, a little bit more well-rounded defensively before all the injuries from the cornerback position to the linebacker position, and he had a lot more help if you're looking just at the offensive side of the ball. So that helped him a lot. He wasn't having to scrap and scratch and score points to the point where the Rams are. When you look at the Rams, their defense is pretty good, but sometimes their Rams offense is not where it needs to be. And a defense that Aaron Donald provides definitely helps that. You look at Jalen Ramsey on the backside of him with the cornerback position, it definitely helps him a lot. But beating triple teams consistently, getting to the quarterback and leading the league in pressures on the quarterback from the defensive tackle position is why I'm choosing Aaron Donald as my Defensive Player of the Year. All you NFL fans, get in the comment section and tell me what you think. Do you think another guy should have been on this list? Who do you think should have been a prediction on the winner? Definitely check us out each and every week on Sports Choice Plus on the YouTube channel. And definitely check out the rest of our archive for our videos for our other award winners. Thank you so very much, and I'll see you soon.